Oh, I can smell it. It smells like burning plastic. You look so scared. Okay, I've got Kx80 1998. It runs. I started it the other day though, and it revs super high. So it could be that my air filter's got a bit of a gap. I'm getting a new one anyway, but I just wanted to see if it started. But that didn't work. And then the choke on here's using a cable tie to keep it down. It's not proper. So I can fix that. I think there's a bit of a gap in here. It's a bit hard too. It's gone a bit weird, so I'll probably replace those, carb, and get a new air filter, which I've got a carb. I've got these, but I don't have an air filter, so I'll swap those around. And the frame on this bike's not as good, so I'm gonna put this frame on. This is a bike project that I had about 2 years ago. I wanted to get it running. It's got a seized engine. I've still got it, but it's a lot of money to get it rebuilt, so I haven't got up to it. But I'm gonna mix the two bikes to make the best bike. This one's a small wheel, and that's a big wheel, so I'm gonna have to swap that onto here. I can't just swap wheels, but yeah, should be good. Got a good setup. There we go. Just have a box of looking. I have taken the gas. I want to take off the gas tank, so I turn the gas off quickly because there's still fuel on this line. There's a bit of fuel still coming out. I quickly got the gas tank and poured the rest of that fuel line in. Went to the gas tank. I don't think I actually dripped any, which is really good. I'm normally terrible with fuel. And then I can take this off now, and then I end up just turning on the gas with this in and wait for it all to drain out of here into that bottle. So now the tank's empty, and I undo the screw here. I gotta undo, and this you gotta pull up and over. I'll do it with two hands. And then I need to take off the shroud, or just that, and it'll come off with the shroud because that's attached to the radiator. But I'm getting there. it. This took about half an hour to get off. It was so tight. But I finally got it off. And I have to try not get any grit in there, but I'm going to polish these on the wire wheel. Should look pretty good. Okay, I've got this on the wire wheel. Looks a lot better. It's not the best, but it looks a lot better. And this one here as well. And I've greased it up, putting it under the bike. Okay. Got shocks and wheel on the frame now. It looks awesome. I'm very happy with it. That's the old frame. Just didn't look nice. It needs to be on here. That looks good. Okay, here's the bike, it's looking great. Here we go, here's the old bike. All the, I don't know, main stuff still in here, engine and everything, but yeah, this one's looking cool. I'm really happy with it. It's good. Just got the wiring out of this bike and cleaned it up a bit, but it's quite dirty. And I put a bit of tape around where some wires were exposed. I should probably buy new wiring. It was pretty damaged, but it's still with us. So this one. Taking out the screw down at the bottom of here and drained all the coolant into a bottle, and now I can take off the radiator and then I can take out the engine because the radiator's got all the fluid on it, so I've drained that out. This is what the bike's looking like, and I can start putting those parts into there. That's what the bike's looking like so far. There's my seized engine. There we go. Just pieces. That's the foundation.